Once you do 4112 after hitting tools, now you're in the installer level programming. It's asking us to connect to the server. Again, it's looking to connect to AlarmNet. Because this system's not yet enabled for monitoring, we're just gonna say no. But now we're into the deeper level installer programming. You have some higher level testing that can be done. You'll also see there's certain things that were in that master level programming within this screen, okay? But they're assuming an installer would have a lot more reason to do deeper level diagnostics and deeper level testing than what the end user will do. The end user doesn't need that because the installer is supposed to have already been doing that. Of course, you as a do-it-yourselfer, you should have access to both, and that can be done here. Same idea, if the installer had to view event logs or export event logs, they have that same functionality. So some of this stuff is doubled up and lives in both levels of programming, but it's just all a matter of who's getting into these levels. Once you hit program, you're actually into the installer level programming, and from here, you have system type, so you have RF code, RF jam, you have some options for tweaking the panel's event log, what's gonna be enabled, what's not gonna be enabled. You still have your date time option. You have the ability to change the installer code. So when we showed you the master code stuff, and we showed you how you can change your master code, your duress code, your guest code, your sub-user codes, you notice that you can't change your installer code through there. And again, it's because Honeywell wants to keep those two levels of programming separate. But once you've used the installer code, then you can change it. Communicator is for your monitoring parameters. Normally that should be reserved for letting your alarm company set that up for you. Nothing that you as an end user would have to do, even if you're doing it, do it yourself. Comm diagnostics is some deeper level programming based around the Wi-Fi or cellular communicator. Zones is probably the most popular thing you'll do within the installer level programming here, and you can scroll down and see all your zones and change and manipulate your zones. Keys is for key fobs, so if you're gonna program key fobs to the panel. Reporter is, again, for stuff for monitoring purposes. This is normally something your monitoring company will set you up on, but there's some levels of options within there. System settings is some basic programming of the system, entry delays, the backlight timeout that we showed you in a different video, and some of the other options that the panel allows you to set up. Sounder allows you to manipulate the time that the siren will sound for. And it can do some other things like arm confirm. And we'll have videos describing all of these features in higher level detail, but we just kind of wanted to give you a rough overview of everything that you can do from within the installer level programming. Z-Wave, you can see if Z-Wave's enabled. Default config is if you wanted to take it back to a factory default. Reset master code. Language, you can actually select the language of the installer level programming and the user level programming. So if you were a homeowner that wanted Spanish for the panel screen, but your installer is English, then you could set it up that way. So that's kind of cool. And then finally, RF keypad is a way to add not the Wi-Fi tablets, but actually the Honeywell wireless keypads that they're going to support as well. So all of that can be done from the installer level of programming. And again, installer level programming is accessed via 4112 code unless you changed it. Master level programming is set via the 1234 master code. So we hope that helps you understand better why there are two levels of programming and why there are two default codes out of the box when you get your Honeywell Lyric. If you have any questions about any programming on your system or which code to use to access which levels of programming, please let us know. We're here to help. And make sure to subscribe to our channel so that you're up to date on all of the great new features of this revolutionary new system.